Hello, 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 everyone. Today, welcome to my cooking life with Jersey Mama. I am Teresa Sedario. I am your Jersey Mama, and I know I haven't been on in about 2 weeks because I was visiting my great nephew and or my nephew and his children, three little girls, and my niece Ashley, his wife. And hello, thanks for jumping on. And so I was away there for 1 week. I came back. Last week I got the flu. And now I know from working in the medical field, from years of it, they would say most people get hit bad with the flu in March. It's like that's the end of it, and that's where they usually get a lot of cases. So the day of the snowstorm last Wednesday, or it was the Wednesday before that, I was in the urgent care. So I couldn't put on my cooking live. And hi, how are ya? So I can't say. Today I decided that I was going to make you, hold on 1 second, let me just turn my Donna Summers down. Okay, I'm back. Today I was going to do everything organic. So I am going to include the picture of what I used, and I will show you how to make this organic salmon. It was organic salmon marinated in teriyaki, honey, and some chopped up garlic. I marinated it in the refrigerator for about an hour and a half. I'm also going to show you, which I already started, is black rice, organic black rice with coconut milk. Now, I know in the picture you're going to see that I used 2 cans of organic coconut milk, but when cooking rice, you never know how it's gonna cook. They say to cook it for 35 to 45 minutes. However, I wind up cooking it for an hour and a half, and I use 3 cans instead to 1 cup of blackened rice. But I had this at my niece's house and my nephew's house when I was there, and Ashley is totally into fitness and health. So I ate very, very healthy those 4 days, 3 days that I was there. And this is one of the dishes that she made, which I absolutely loved. And I'll share the other one next time with you. She made an awesome chicken pate over rice noodles, which was fabulous. So, but what I did here is in my pan, and I'm going to have roasted vegetables, asparagus and broccoli. So what I did in my pot, can you see my pot? Let me turn this around. Thanks for hopping on, folks. Listen, as I always say, if you like, share my video. All you have to do is hit share and like my Facebook page, and I include that in my in the beginning of the blurb, the comments up at the top of my video. So, or it might be at the bottom. I don't know how it comes online, but I will include the recipe for the ricotta pie, because we're going to have ricotta pie. The Easter ricotta pie, and but I just wanted to tell you what I did. You know what? Before I do that, I want to tell you what I did in the pot, okay? In my pot, I cooked for an hour and a half because I don't like the rice comes out al dente if you cook it the way they want you to cook it. I mean, really, it has a bite to it. However, I didn't want to have that kind of bite to it, and I wanted it to be just a little bit more softer, especially for the older folks that have problems with their teeth and have separation. I don't want them to get that feeling if they're going to try it. So what I did here, and I'm going to show you, is I got 1 cup of black rice, and you can get it at Trader Joe's. You can get the organic at Whole Foods or anywhere you go that you buy your organic produce and food. And this is what it looks like once it's cooked down. Can you see that? Okay. This is really, really good because it's cooked with coconut milk. And the flavor with the salmon and the teriyaki salmon and honey it's just like a burst of flavor. It's just so darn good. So what I did was I put the cup of rice in there. I rinsed my rice. Make sure you rinse your black rice or rinse any rice. And I threw it in there with 3 cans of coconut milk, okay? I cooked it for an hour and a half, like I said, so this way it's not real... that has a bite or something. You know, I don't like it al dente. I don't like my rice al dente. Okay. What I'm going to do real fast here is I got some olive oil in here. I'm going to throw, let me get a spoon. about a teaspoon of chopped garlic. Remember, always chop your garlic. I always like to do that before I cook some meals because this way I have it fresh. It's already chopped. I put some olive oil in it, put it in a sealed container in the refrigerator, stays for about 2 weeks. Okay? So here I already chopped up. You know what? Let me stir this. Now, can you imagine what the roasted vegetables would taste like if you sauteed your olive oil and garlic first, but didn't think of that. I'm going to put my broccoli in there. I chop it up like this, that size. You can make it smaller. You know, you can make it like this. It's whatever you want. I'm going to mix this up. I already have my oven preheated at 350. Okay, throw some salt, pepper. Oh my God, does anybody remember this song? This was back in my day. I love it. Oh my God, let me tell you something. Back in the day, while I'm stirring this, I'll tell you a quick story. My husband had friends, there was about 9 of them. There was PD Lab, there was Jeff Casella, there was, I don't even know if I can mention names. I know PD. PD, if you're watching me, hi. There was Mike, there was Ronnie Scagno, there was like 9 of them that was the crew, okay? Here, I touched my hair, I better wipe my hands. So anyway, we were going to see, it was the Tramps, and it was during the disco era, the Tramps and somebody else, and we were waiting all the way back in the line of this hotel where they were. Okay. So I already, what I did, let me show you else what I did before I get back to the story. I used in a pan parchment paper. I sprayed it. I'm going to put the broccoli over here on this side. I'm going to throw the asparagus. I like to cut my asparagus like this, this size. I hate the rest of the part. I only like this part, so that's what I do. Teaspoon of chopped garlic, salt, pepper, olive oil. Oh. Use what's left of the olive oil. Nope. Here's my favorite olive oil from Tales of the Olive in Hamilton and in Williamstown Farmers Market. This is garlic-infused olive oil. You go in there, it's amazing. It's amazing. I had to take a stop at the main store to go see what it looks like, and I did post it at one point on Facebook. Okay. So I stir that up real good. On the opposite side, I'm going to put the asparagus. I know, you know, some people say, she's using her hands. Don't worry, I'll wipe my hands next. Because I don't like olive oil on my hands. But remember back in the day, to use everything, you wind up washing, putting your hands in there to get it. So anyway, get back to the story. We were all the way in the back. All the way in the back at the Cherry Hill, I think it was the hotel, and this is where they were performing. Well, my husband and his friends, because they think they were so cool back there, they were bad. They were bad to the bone. In fact, that I think was the phrase we used, bad to the bone. So anyway, I'm going to put this over here to the side because I'm going to get the salmon ready. So they wind up getting us in. We were all the way in the back, and we walked in the door. We were right up front, and they all came back. The girls all stayed in line. They said, come on, girls, and they went to go talk to the guy in the front, and they got us in instead of waiting, because I was 15, and I had to be home by 12 o'clock. And it figures, as the tramps were starting, I had to leave. But we walked in the doors, and when you opened up, there was music, disco music going everywhere, and people were spinning. They're doing the New York hustle, and who's flying, and oh my God, it was like so amazing when you're 15, and you know, that's your era, and you just love that music, and you love to dance. Oh my goodness, we had such a good time. The tramps were amazing, but anyway, that's my little story. But my husband, today's his day off, so he went to go do some errands. I said, come and say hi to everybody so you can see what my husband looks like. Because if you ever see me write H-U-Z-Z-B-A-N-D, well, that's my husband. Okay. So in this bag here, I have three salmon, organic salmon pieces marinated in teriyaki, garlic, and honey. Sesame seeds on this. So I have it for I have 350. The oven is 350. You're going to put this in for about 20 minutes to a half hour. So on here, I'm going to open up, put the salmon in one, and I want to put the vegetables in the other side. Let that cook. Let's get this stuff. I'll use that for later. I'll organize my stuff. Here goes my rag to wipe my hands. Again, even though I washed them, I still feel oil. Okay. Now, excuse me. Here we go. I'm going to have a coughing fit soon. Here's my water. Oh my God, it's so hot in here. Hold on, I gotta open up the window. Whew. You know, sometimes I gotta take my socks off and my sneakers. Because now I'm hot. I hate when my feet are covered and it's during warm weather season. Oh my God. Throw them over there. Wash my hands. Okay. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you, let me put this for 30 minutes. Okay. I'm going to show you how to make the ricotta pie. Now, just so you know, what I did already is I already made the crust because it takes time for the crust. What I do is, because I don't like when you get a pie, especially when you make the ricotta pie and you make the, you don't throw the dough in first, because then when you cut the pie, it's all white and it's like, I can't stand that look. I can't stand it. It's like white. It looks like it's not cooked. So I pre-cook my pie sheet, or the crust, for about 10 minutes. So this way it's already pre-cooked. Then I pour the batter in it. Only because, like I said, I don't like that white film that you get on the bottom. Hold on. Oh, God. Okay. Sorry about the song, folks, but I like Donna Summers. So anyway, I am going to bring you over here, and hopefully I'll have good lighting. And I'm going to show you how to make, let's see, put it this way. Can you see this? Okay. Let me get my ingredients. All we need is my phone to go off now, right? Okay. I love when my husband's home. He beats my rugs. He was beating the rug today. Drop this on the floor. Okay, so I gotta put my glasses on for this one. But I'm gonna put the recipe. So if you have a pencil and paper, get it out. Even though I will include the recipe. The filling for the ricotta pie is 3 pounds of ricotta. So that's the big chobani or whatever you use. 12 eggs. This will make 2 pies. 1.5 cups of sugar. 1/2 cup of flour. 1 teaspoon of vanilla. You can use the lemon and orange rind. I am using, because I don't have oranges, I'm improvising. So you use what you have. I'm going to use tangerine. I'll use the tangerine this time. You're going to bake it at 350 for 1 hour until firmness, okay? You could sprinkle when you're done. You could sprinkle, or before it goes in, some cinnamon on top of it. When you cook this, and it's sometimes you get like a little, if you ever cooked ricotta pie before, when you bake it, after when it comes to the end, you can see where it's all cooked, and then sometimes you'll see like a little circle in the middle, and it looks like it's not cooked. You could leave it in there for no more than 5 minutes, because eventually it is cooking, only because of the fact if not, you dry out the pie and it'll cause the pie to crack if you cook it any longer. So I have a big pie plate. This fits your regular normal size pie plate, but I have a big pie plate that I cook with because of everybody that I usually cook for. Yeah, we're empty nesters. Guess what? I'm going to have all this stuff. I'm going to have to give it to my kids so this way they have it now. So this way they can cook. So anyway, so that's it. Okay. So I am going to put the sugar. I always shake my vanilla because I always think there's like sediment. Sediment at the bottom, so I shake it. But did you know also that if you can't find a teaspoon or you ran out of teaspoon, this little cup is a teaspoon. So if you can't find your spoons, your measuring spoons, just you could use that. Slowly add the eggs. This is going to be a little loud. Oh, it would be nice if I plugged it in, right? How many people like ricotta pie? I mean, I don't know anybody that really doesn't. I love ricotta pie. What did they do? Oh. This KitchenAid saves my whole cooking and baking for the holiday, because I went through 1 year baking cookies. Almost lit my boob right off. 1 year I went through three hand mixers, and they burnt out because I usually make a double batch. I wanted to get this stuff done because I got to, you know, when you bake for your mother, you bake for your mother-in-law, you bake for, you know, whoever. And yourself, you try to leave some stuff for yourself. By the time your kids get it, you got to do it again. Okay, so I already put the sugar in there with the vanilla. I'm going to incorporate the eggs. They say cook your wet ingredients first. When you make your, that's what they tell you to do. I should have whipped the eggs first. I'm going to get somebody that says, you didn't whip the eggs first. Well, you should have whipped the eggs first. Sorry. But, I whipped the eggs. I'm going to stop it. I'm going to get the ricotta. Thank you. gee, I hope I get everything done. I mean, at least I was kind of trying to figure out the timing on the salmon and the, I'm up to 22 minutes. Okay. So you incorporate the ricotta with the egg mixture and your vanilla. Okay. You want it till it's creamy. You want your ricotta creamy. So, this way you don't have any lumps in it or not. You just, you know, I don't have to tell everybody what to do. I'm sure you all know what to do, right? By the way, please share my video. I would appreciate it. Please like it. Please share it. Please put some hearts if you like what you see what I'm cooking. I forgot to do my salute. My liquid gold. Can't do without it every single day. Salute. Okay. So that as that's incorporating. I have a dry dish here. I'm going to get my tangelo or whatever, orange. You can use an orange. You can, like I said, you can use a lemon. You just take the rind. I think I'm going to add a little bit of the juice to it, only because I love that citrus. I like the citrusy flavor of the oranges or any type of like that produce. And it gives it just a nice light flavor. The lemon gives an excellent flavor. Now, as far as the as far as the pie crust is concerned, you can use a pie crust that's like your Pillsbury pie crust. However, this pie crust was excellent. I love it. It has a little sugar to it, so it's a little sweeter. Thanks to Rose. She's amazed. She's the one that showed me how to make the quiche that I made before. Okay, let me turn this off. Oh, I got to add the flour. Sorry, folks. The little flour that I got to add. And baking powder. Okay, so as far as the crust is concerned, it's 2 cups of flour. It's 1 tablespoon of baking powder, 1 pinch of salt, 2 eggs, 4 teaspoons of sugar, 1 stick of butter melted, right? Well, you know it's going to be good right there, especially if it has the butter and the sugar. Because I kind of like the sweeter pie crust, so it just tastes so much better for me. I like it that way. And this recipe is amazing, because she's such a great baker. So let me scrape this. How many of you were raised with ricotta pie? On Easter. I wasn't. Actually, this is a tradition my mother-in-law used to make. I never had it until I tasted hers, and I had it, like, from my aunts, but I don't remember my grandmother or anything making it, but I have had it when I was little, but I never saw the making of everything. So, my mother-in-law, Easter morning, we would go to church with the kids and then head over her house. She would have an Easter egg hunt for the kids. And she had the ham pie and she had the ricotta pie and then she had the Easter bread. So that was our way of breaking Lent. And fond memories. God bless her. I sometimes feel like she's here because she lived with me for 8 years. So, or close to that. And we used to go back and forth with my sister-in-law, Carol. Okay. Let me check on this. So I will answer any questions that anybody has. afterwards because of my vision issue, and it's hard for me to read this fine print and what everybody's doing or saying. So I will answer any questions afterwards, and I will respond to each and every one of you that have questions. So, like I said, please share my page, and please share go like my Facebook page and the cooking part of it, the Cooking Live with Jersey Mama. And please share my video. Okay. All right. Unfortunately, this is not going to be done. Do you believe this? I can't believe it's not going to be done. Let me just bump this up. 375. So you're going to place this in a pie shell. I didn't do one of my 30-minute meals, that's for sure. It might have been one of my 30-minute putting everything together, but I wanted you to see how I cooked everything, so... Like I said, this usually makes, it makes two normal-sized pie crusts, or pies, but unfortunately, because I use such a big one, it's so creamy. I could smell the tangerine. Get some salmon. Sprinkle a little bit on top. I always use too much. You're going to stick this in the oven. At 350 for an hour. And then you could take it out and you let it set. You put it in the refrigerator. You can have it for Easter. And, let's see here. I can't believe it's not done. I can't believe my salmon's not done and my roasted vegetables. For some reason, I just didn't time this right. I can't believe this. You know? God, I'm off my game. I was off 2 weeks and I'm off my game. Okay. Oh, the salmon's done. The salmon is done. This is done. What am I talking about? Okay. Put my pie in. Lower it back to 350. Press start. 60 minutes. 1 hour. Here you go. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. Put it in for 350 for 1 hour. Set the timer. The smell that's going to be through your house is going to be unbelievable. I am going to put my rice. Okay, now we're going to have to go this way. I needed a cameraman. My husband should have stayed today, right? Here's my black rice. Yeah, what a taste. Okay, so this is what it looks like, folks. You have your asparagus, you have your broccoli, you have your black rice, and you have your salmon. The honey on the salmon mixed with the teriyaki, the coconut with the rice, just says yum. Just says yum. Bless the mother. This is so unbelievably good. I am Teresa Sedario. I am your Jersey mama. I look forward to seeing you next time. And I wish everyone a happy Easter filled with lots of memories with your family, with the grandchildren, and your whoever you get with. So have a happy Easter, everyone. Jersey mama signing off. Have a good day.